going to open up the election choir, following the election choir. The military will come and perform their life. man in the presence of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, family, friends of the family, who has gathered together here again for celebrating life and the going home services of one fair Smiley. Sunset, August 31st, 1952. Sunset, June 16th, 2022, here at the Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church. Program has been provided, and we will follow the program. Otherwise, no change from the family to follow the program as it has been. Scripture will be given by Old Testament by Reverend Dr. John Evans, the New Testament by Reverend Dr. Alan Jackson, Prayer of Comfort by Reverend Dr. Evan Jackson, and Reverend Soto by Reverend Dr. Evan Shakers, in that order.
Revelations chapter 14, and we'll begin at verse 12. We find these words that are written. It says, here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, wife, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, save the spirit, that they may rest from their labor, and their works do follow them. Word of God for the people.
Amen. Let us pray. Oh God, I help you. In ages past, I hope the years to come. Our shelter from the stormy blast, and our eternal home. O God, we come before you today with thanksgiving and praise. Father, we come thanking you because you are so good to us. Father, we praise you even in times like these. For you are a sustainer, you are a keeper, you are a deliverer, you are our leading hope. God, you are our everything. Even when we feel like we've lost it all, God, you're able to pick us up, turn us around, help us to have purpose and to move on. We come thanking you, Father, for the life of our sister. Praying, Lord God, for her family right now, that you would strengthen them during this hour of grief, knowing that you
Help them to know you if they do not know you, Lord God. Help them to lean on you as they never leaned on you before.
Yes.
And we will be so careful to give you all praise, glory, and honor. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Let the church say amen.
Thank you. Without the, called each other by our last names, but she always said, Martha. Anyone that knows Smiley knows that she was proper and a lady at all times. But one thing I want you to know about Smiley, when she didn't like something, you knew it. Because before she spoke, her eyes told the story. She was one of our best training officers at the Sheriff's Department. If you did not do your job right, you was not allowed to be alone on the floors with the inmates until you have an extended training again through her. Because once she released you, you had to do your job. Through the years, we became friends. She was a stubborn little thing sometimes. But that was my friend. He cried, he talked, and she was kind. She was silent. But at the same time, she had two things that she always loved. Bowling, singing. She loved to sing. She sung like a bird. The voice of an angel. You go miss mine. But once, I said she loved two things, but I left one out. She loved the Lord. Amen. She loved the Lord. Mom and the rest of the Smiley family, sleep on my friend by true admission. Sleep on. It's gonna be hard. Praying and asking God for strength, and He'll give you the strength that you need to endure. I love you. Amen.
We will continue then, selected by the St. Luke and St. Baptist Church Choir. Thank you.
to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. We, the 1970 class of the historic Liberty County High School, McIntosh, Georgia, pause to pay our tribute of respect to the memory of our friend and classmate, Fairlee Smiley. Our hearts are heavy as we say farewell to one of our own. Whereas Fairlee's passing has caused another link to drop from our chain, it is broken, and we pause to ask the one that can, our Lord and Savior, to reconnect the remaining links. Whereas with Fairlee's answering of her call, there is now a deeper void. It has caused great sadness to our classmates and in our community at large. Whereas we pause to remember, to reflect, and to celebrate the life of our beloved friend and classmate. We celebrate the life that she enjoyed here on earth and thank our Lord and Savior for each precious moment, each precious memory that we shared with her. Whereas Fairlee was known for her bold and loving spirit and was always willing to lend a helping hand. She was also known for her athletic and singing abilities. She truly had a winning personality and was a great leader. We are proud that Fairlee was part of our class. Therefore, be it resolved that we bow in humble submission to God, who never makes a mistake, and remind the family to be encouraged. We commend you to Him who knows best. Be it further resolved that we will always remember Fairlee, our classmate, and the good times, the fun times, and those unforgettable moments we shared. We remain the mighty, mighty Tigers. We will always strive not to equal, but to excel. Be it further resolved that we will always remember to extend our sincere love, especially to the Smiley family and Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church family. Humbly submitted on the 24th day of June 2022, classmates of the historic Liberty County class of 1970, Reverend Dr. James Evans, class of 1970, Reverend Dr. Edith Walknight Anderson, class of 1970, Sally Quarterman, class of 1970. We, the family of the late Fairlee Smiley, wish to acknowledge with sincerity and appreciation the many prayers, calls, cards, visits, words of comfort, and deeds of kindness during the loss of our precious loved one. We pray God will abundantly bless each of your lives forever.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Thank you very kindly. Obituary read silently, and I know that all of us have read the obituary already. Once we receive a program, two things we do. We take out the altar service, and then we read the obituary. So I know all of us have read it already. I have been knowing the Smiley family just about all of my life. Father and the rest of the sisters, and the father, Deacon Warnell E, was a man, a real man. A man that loved Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church. He could pray, and he could sing. And one of the songs I love to hear him sing that was, "Lowdown Charity, Let Me Know." And when he started riding on that Travis, it seemed like he didn't want to stop. He wanted to come on. And we thank God for being one that Smiley, and thank God for the Smiley family. Amen. A very beautiful family, a very loving and a very caring family. And thank God for the board, the board's family as well as the Smiley's family. Thank God for you. May God continue to bless and strengthen and keep you, is my prayer. And just know that earth has no sorrows, that heaven cannot heal. God bless you in a very special way. Eulogy has been designated by Reverend Dr. James L. Evans, and he will come down to give us words of comfort, and maybe in the process give us words of warning. Let us know that Fairlee Day is here, but ours is yet to come.
Yes,
amen. One day, we will come by this way as well. So Dr. Evans will come down to let us hear a word from the Lord, a word of comfort and words of warning. Dr. James L. Evans. Let's give God a praise as we come. Good to be thought of.
Amen.
When I think about Fairlee, she was a very unique person. She had her own style. She didn't care who liked it.
Amen.
It's good to be real.
Amen.
So much phoniness in the world. I love being around real folk.
Amen.
As it was already stated that in the resolution, I met Fairlee first in the first grade. Hinesville Elementary. Over on Ball Street. Fairlee was a fighter. Trained to fight. A fighter will always give his or her best shot.
Come on now.
A fighter will fight to win.
Say that, say that.
She was a winner. A fighter will fight to the very end. And she did that. I know for a fact that Fairlee Smiley was a fighter.
wife and I were talking the other day, and she and Fairlee and Bob played on the same basketball team, along with Carrie.
Amen.
Amen. Wave your hand. Back then, when they were playing, they started out, they didn't play full court, they played half.
Amen.
Fairlee was a defender.
Yes.
It's good to have a defender in your corner. Wife bought something back to my remembrance the other day. Back when she was still in the military and I was working civil service, she had helped me with a project I was working on. And the project was finished. I told her, I said, one day, I said, Fairlee, I want to take you out to lunch. She said, okay. So the day came for me to take her out to lunch. The Holy Ghost is real.
Mm-hmm.
The Holy Ghost said, you better call your wife and let her know. Hinesville is a small place. And you well known. Office and picked her up. And back then there was a restaurant named Maley's. Mm-hmm. We were sitting there eating, and sure enough, there was some folk in there that knew me.
Mm-hmm.
We had a big laugh. I said, Fairlee, now before I get back, somebody gonna call my wife.
Mm-hmm.
Tell her that I was having lunch with another woman.
Mm-hmm.
Lo and behold, in the house of God, I won't lie. My wife said, called me when I got back there. She said, I told you. God is a good God.
Yes,
he is. Fairlee was a fighter.
Mm.
She served her country as a soldier. Soldiers learn how to fight.
Mm.
Uncle Sam didn't have to teach Fairlee much about fighting. I stated earlier, we first met in the first grade. How many of you will agree with me that some things in life you will never forget? If my memory served me right, I was in three fights during my school years. I won one. One was a draw. And I lost one. And the one I lost came at the hands of my sister. Sister Fairlee. I was so glad when them teachers pulled her off of me. They become your best friend. I ain't been able to figure that one out. I had a little talk with a bird the other day. Learned that she was a fireball. She didn't mind telling you just put it on my mind.
Yeah.
Like it or not. She was a fighter. And she fought until there was no more fight in her. I believe that she went down swinging, saying to herself, it's not over until God said, it's over. Yes, I know. I can hear say, I know what the doctors are saying.
Uh-huh.
I know what my body is telling me. But it's not over until God says it's over. Dr. Jackson read the scripture from Revelation. I heard the voice from heaven saying, unto me, right, blessed are the dead that die in the Lord. Henceforth, yeah, said the Spirit,
come on now,
that they rest from their labor,
yes,
and their works to follow them.
Come on.
God Almighty, we're all working, or should be working, while we have a chance.
Yes.
As Christians, we serve the Lord because of our great indebtedness to Him, who crucified, who was crucified for our sins on a cross of Calvary, and opened the door to reconciliation with our Creator. Therefore, we serve the Lord out of gratitude for the things that He has done for us. John wrote on the Isle of Patmos that the dead are blessed. What makes our deceased loved one blessed is because she walked with the Lord.
Say that.
I read in program because he gave her life to the Lord at an early age. See, if you come along during the baby boomer years, baby boomer, all we knew was church. I can remember when the little church was right over there. But all we did was church. We didn't have an option. We couldn't say, well, I ain't feeling well today. Mama said, hit the floor, we hit the floor. Fairly. Was a praiser.
Come on now.
God gifted her with a beautiful voice.
Yeah.
And she didn't mind using it.
Mm-hmm.
Some folk, you have to beg them to sing.
Yeah.
But if God's Spirit is in you,
yeah,
you don't mind praising the Lord. John says, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord.
Yeah.
Death is a blessing only to those who have confessed Christ as their Savior and are released from the confines of this sinful world. Blessing comes when we no longer suffer persecution, sickness, financial struggles, all the challenges we face in the flesh. We are free when we are connected to our power source. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You got to know that you know that you're free in God. We're free. And the song says, no longer bound, no more. Chains holding. My soul is resting. Oh, what a blessing. Good God Almighty. Rest assured, there is no reward unless you are in the Lord.
Yes.
All right. Talking about a righteous reward. When you are in the Lord, you are partakers of the heavenly offer of forgiveness from sin. And once you have confessed your needs of a Savior, you are committed to serve in His kingdom. God Almighty. Not just to give, but to sacrifice. Fairlee was a giver. She sacrificed that others might have. Not just to watch, but to partake. In other words, you got to get in the water when the water is stirred. Not just to sympathize, but to comfort. I'm going to miss the little video call she and I used to have. First time we talked, we didn't use the video way to see one another. She said, well, I'm going to change that. James. I said, yes, ma'am. She said, from now on when we talk, I want to look you in the eye. Amen. I'm going to miss our little chats. Because we had a way of encouraging one another. Every now and then, everyone needs a little encouragement. With God Almighty. Not just to pray, but to believe. Not to work. Work without whining. To help and not hurt. To comfort and not criticize. Our beloved sister led such a life. John went on to say, they shall rest from the labors. Early professed this great faith in our heavenly reward. Was rest. She served unselfishly and generously, sacrificing time and talent, knowing that in the end she would win. Anybody that didn't know her knew she was a winner. And the victory would be rest. No more battles to fight. No more temptation to resist. No more responsibility to shoulder. No more valleys to cross. No more burdens to bear. Some of you may be wondering why she put so much energy in her Christian service. For the Bible says we must serve the Lord with gladness. Come before His presence with singing. We should not not to prime you up. Enter the house and worship the Lord. You ought to come with a praise. Don't be ashamed to praise the true and the living God. Not only when you feel good, but praise Him when you feel bad. Praise Him when you're down. Drives us on it as soldiers in the Lord's army. Rest is our eternal reward for a job well done.
Yes.
I want to hear him say one day, well done! When there is no more sorrow, when there is no more pain. No more danger. No more strength. Yes, Sister Fairlee, Smiley, going on to rest. The last mountain has been climbed. The last valley crossed. The last cross carried. The last trial endured. And the last fear faced. I can hear her saying, I fought a good fight. And I finished my course. With God's might. Lastly, John goes on to say, their works follow them. What John does, what do he mean by that? How can a person work follow him or her? Well, let's look at the example, the life she lived. She worked while it was there. And when her health began to fail, she didn't stop loving on God. She always had a word for him. Yes, my brothers and my sisters. Her works would not be forgotten. This great example of Christianity shall live on in the hearts and the minds of those who really knew her. We shall lift works up as an example to all believers. Amen. Dr. Anderson said we need to warn folks that one day we too are going to come this way. We don't know when. And we don't know where. But sooner or later, it shall come. And we pray that this life of service will be a driving force to those who are serving Jesus the Christ. Back doing. The days and after, the way back then, the Greeks, they had games that they did. One of them was a race. And in this race, torchbearers would run a race at night. The history say that the starting point was a mile and a half outside the city. Starting at an olive grove. And when been the race begun.
All right.
The finish line was well within the city.
Yes,
and the runner who reached it first with his torch still burning, they will gain the prize. Yes, I believe Fairlee ran her race. And she kept her torch burning. And she got the prize. I'm certain today that Fairlee has run her race well. And she has won the prize. Yes, as she arrived at the finish line. Her light was still burning. For I heard the prophet Daniel say, they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn men into righteousness as the stars from everlasting to everlasting. She ran a race. And she ran it well. Good God Almighty. And then the finish line. She finished. Time for rest. From disappointments. Finished. Time from rest from hardship. Finished. Time from rest from battle and birth. Good God Almighty.
Yeah. Thank you.
We therefore commit the body back to the God that giveth, earth to earth, ash to ashes, and dust to dust. I heard the voice from heaven saying unto me, cry, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord, and therefore they rest from their labor and their works do follow them. Grace be unto you and peace from the God of our Father, from the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Sleep on, my sister.